Hi all, Andy from Solar Reviews again, and I just wanted to make a video today about how much it costs to run the various Tesla cars, both from the grid and also how much solar and how much a solar system will cost if you want to contemplate the extra energy you need to run them, and then also compare that to gas cars. So to work out the amount of kilowatt hours you need, we simply work out how many kilowatt hours we need per mile that we drive. Because the thing we know is how many miles we drive typically a month, you may not, but I'm gonna work all these out assuming that you drive 1,000 miles a month. So with a Tesla Model 3 long range, we've got a 358 mile range. Then we're talking that we need approximately 4.3 miles to every kilowatt. So to drive 1,000 miles, we need about 207 kilowatt hours of power. If we were to power that from the grid, grid power averages about 13 cents a kilowatt hour across the country. So 200 kilowatt hours, give or take, at 13 cents a kilowatt hour is about $26 a month. However, if you charge your Tesla Model 3 with solar, it actually works out at a lower cost. The long range cost of solar, depending on exactly what you pay for system, but assuming about a $3 a watt cost for an installed residential system, then to generate 200 kilowatt hours a month, you're generally looking at about a 2 kilowatt system, depending on where you live. So if you live in the northeast where there's less sun, then you might need more panels to generate that 200 kilowatt hours a month. If you live, you know, in the southwest, then you might need less panels. So 1 kilowatt of solar on average gives us, in the coldest, you know, darkest climates in the country, maybe 800-900 kilowatt hours a year per 1 kilowatt of solar installed, and in the sunniest places, 1400 or 1500 kilowatt hours per 1 kilowatt of solar. With the Model 3, we're looking at, if we power it with solar, we need an extra 2 kilowatts of solar to do that on average. So we take sort of a midpoint, if you like, and your cost is about $20 a month. So compare that to a grid cost. That grid cost is likely to be anywhere from $26 to $40 a month if we power it from the utility grid. But if we compare that to a gas car with 25 miles to the gallon efficiency as a midpoint, assuming a gas price of about $4 a gallon, that same car would cost about $160 a month. So the electric car saving, you know, we're looking at about, you know, between $130 to $140 a month. So, you know, $1,500, $1,600 a year, plus probably another $700 or $800 a year in lower running costs from the lower maintenance requirements for electric vehicles. And so, you know, there's a saving there of about $2,000 across the range. Now, if we go up to the Model S, we've got a 400 mile range on the long range with a 100 kilowatt hour battery. So in that case, we get about 4 miles, so slightly less miles for every kilowatt of power that we use from the battery. So in that case, we need about a 2.4 kilowatt system. At $3 a watt, that'll be, you know, between $6,000 and $7,000, but after the tax credit, brings it back to about $5,000 as a one-off cost. But if you absorb that cost, then, you know, you're never paying a cent for fuel again versus paying gas forever. So, and again, if you powered that car, I mean, that equates to about $25 a month as a cost if you amortize that over the life of the system. And again, if you powered that from the grid, you'd be at about between about $35 and $50 a month, depending on where exactly in the country you live. And again, you know, you would be against a cost to run a gas-powered car at around $160 a month if we assume the same gas car being used as a comparison. So again, significant savings. If we're talking about the Model Y, then we've got 330 miles of range on a 74 kilowatt hour battery. You're basically talking that you need about 2.6 kilowatts of solar on average across the country to power it. So not significantly different to the Model S there. The one where there's probably a little bit of a change is the Model X. The Model X, we've got a 348 mile range with our 100 kilowatt battery. So the maths there is pretty easy. You're getting, you know, 3.48 miles for every kilowatt of power. you know, so you need about 287 kilowatt hours of power a month. And so you're up to about a 2.7, 2.8 kilowatts of solar on average. To give you an idea, roughly in terms of to break this down into a number of panels, residential panels now are mainly around 400 watts. And so you're talking, if it's a 2.8 kilowatt system, you know, then you're talking about seven panels. You know, with the Model 3, where we're talking about a 2 kilowatt system, then we're probably talking about five extra panels on your solar system. So again, you know, with the Model X, if we power it from solar, we're probably, our cost, you know, is a bit over $7,000 pre-tax credit. After the tax credit, it's about $5,500. And again, it works out to around $30 a month versus powering it from the grid, which would be about $40 a month if you live in an area where power prices are at around that 12, 13 cents a kilowatt hour. But if you live in places where power prices are 20 cents or more, then that's more likely to be $50 or $60 a month. But again, it all compares to a gas car at about $160 a month if we assume the car, a comparable car. With the Model X, you may actually be assuming a car that actually uses more fuel per mile driven, so it may actually be slightly more. So that's a basic rundown of how much it costs to run a Tesla, both, you know, with solar, with the grid, and how it compares to gas cars. On a more broader view, though, if you forget the Tesla name, you know, because there's many other electric cars and a great, much greater range of electric cars coming out every day. More manufacturers are making more, giving you more choice with electric cars. But with anyone, you can do the maths. You simply work back by, you know, dividing the range by the battery size, working out how many kilowatt hours of power you need for every mile you drive, and then using the amount of miles you drive to work maths back. And you can work out, based on a average grid price of say 13 cents a kilowatt hour up to sort of 20, 25 cents a kilowatt hour in some other places, based on what you use and where you live, and how many miles you drive, you can work those numbers out for yourself. Electric cars are probably one of the biggest technical change that's going on in our society at the moment, and a very, very important change in our fight against climate change. And so I hope this video helps. If it does, please like and subscribe. If you're actually interested in getting a solar system because you want to power an electric car, or even maybe just because you want to eliminate your electricity bill, then in the description you'll find a link to our solar calculator, solarreviews.com/solar-calculator, and there, without putting in any personal details, from just your address or the zip code you live in and the amount of your most recent monthly electric bill, that solar calculator can tell you how many solar panels you'd need to wipe out that bill, how much they're likely to cost, and how much they're likely to save you over the life of the system. And if you wish, after getting those results and reading that estimate, you can register if you wish and request quotes from between one and four of the great local solar companies that we have all over America that are passionate about solar and its effect on our society and its ability to help fight climate change. So that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, be sure to subscribe and check out our other content.